வணக்கம். 9th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் இங்கிலீஷ் மீடியம் சயின்ஸ் யூனிட் 17 அனிமல் கிங்டம் டெக்ஸ்ட் புக் எக்ஸசைசஸ் சூஸ் த கரெக்ட் ஆன்சர் ஃபைண்ட் த குரூப் ஹேவிங் ஒன்லி மெரைன் மெம்பர்ஸ் ஆன்சர் ஆப்ஷன் சி எக்கினோடெர்மேட்டா செகண்ட் க்வெஸ்டின் Mesoglia is present in answer option B Coelenterata third question which one of the following birds is not a pyclothermic animal answer option C aves and mammals question number 4 Identify the animal having four-chambered heart. Answer, option C, crocodile. The animal without skull is? Answer, option A, acrania. Hermaphrodite organisms are? Answer, option B, hydra. Tapeworm, earthworm, ascidian. Seventh question. Pyclothermic organisms are? Option C. Fish, frog, lizard, snake. Question number 8. Air sacs and pneumatic bones are seen in? Answer. Option C. Bird. Question number 9. Excretory organ of tapeworm is? Answer. Option A. Flame cells. Question number 10. Water vascular system is found in? Answer. Option C. Starfish. Fill in the blanks. The skeletal framework of porifera is dash spiculus. Tenidia are respiratory organs in dash mollusca. Scates are dash fishes. Cartilaginous fishes. Fourth question. The larva of an amphibian is dash tadpole. Dash are jawless vertebrates. Dash is the unique characteristic feature of mammal. Placenta is the unique characteristic feature of mammal. Seventh question. Spiny anteater is an example for dash mammal. Answer, egg-laying. State whether true or false. If false, correct the statement. First question. Canal system is seen in coelenterates. Answer false. Not coelenterates, it is porifera. The correct statement is canal system is seen in porifera. Second question. Hermaphrodite animals have both male and female sex organs. Answer true. Third question. Trachea are the respiratory organ of annelida. Answer false. Trachea or the respiratory organ of arthropoda. Fourth question. Bipinnaria is the larva of mollusca. Answer false. Bipinnaria is the larva of echinodermata. The correct statement is Bipinnaria is the larva of echinodermata. Fifth question. Balanoglossus is a ciliary feeder. Answer true. Sixth question. Fishes have two chambered heart. True. Seventh question. Skin of reptilians are smooth and moist. Answer false. Not reptilians, it is amphibians. Skin of amphibians are smooth and moist. Eighth question. Wings of birds are the modified forelimbs. Answer true. Wings of birds are the modified forelimbs. Ninth question. Female mammals have mammary glands. Answer true. Female mammals are mammary glands. Match the following. Here phylum and examples are given. In phylum, Coelenterata, Platyhelminths, Echinodermata, Mollusca are given. And examples are shuffled. We have to match it correctly. We can see the answer. Coelenterata, Hydra. Coelenterata, the example is Hydra. Platyhelminths, tapeworm. Platyhelminths, tapeworm. Echinodermata, starfish. Echinodermata, starfish. Mollusca, snail. Mollusca, snail. Answer very briefly. Define taxonomy. It is the theoretical study of classification, including its basic principles, procedures, and rules. What is nematocyst? The tentacles of coelenterates like hydra, jellyfishes, bear stinging cells called nematocysts. They are helpful in defense and used for capturing the prey. Why coelenterates are called diploblastic animals? The body wall of coelenterates are made up of two layers, outer ectoderm and inner endoderm. Hence, it is known as diploblastic animals. Fourth question, list the respiratory organs of amphibians. The respiratory organs of amphibians are gills, skin, buccal, pharynx, and lungs. The respiratory organs of amphibians are gills, skin, buccal, pharynx, and lungs. How does locomotion take place in starfish? Starfish locomotes with the help of tube feet. It has two types of locomotion. One, locomotion on a horizontal surface. Second one, locomotion on vertical surface. Sixth question. Are jellyfish and starfish similar to fishes? If no, justify the answer. No, the two organisms belong to different category. Jellyfish belongs to the phylum Coelenterata. Starfish belongs to the phylum Echinodermata. Fish belongs to the phylum Chordata. Seventh question. Why are frogs said to be amphibians? As frog lives both in the water and on land, they are called as amphibians. The larval form of frog is aquatic. Answer briefly. Give an account on phylum Annelida. Answer. They are metamerically segmented, that is, repeated homologous organs in each segment. They have body cavity called colon. The presence of movable bristles involved in locomotion or sithi. Body is covered with outermost cuticle providing protection. Excretion is through nephridia. The central nervous system is composed of brain. The trochopore larva is a common larva of Annelida. Example, earthworm, leech. Second question. Differentiate between flatworms and roundworms. Flatworms. It belongs to the phylum Platyhelminths. Roundworms. It belongs to the phylum Ashelminths. Flatworms. Elementary canal is absent or simple. Roundworms. The elementary canal is a straight tube. Flatworms. Body is segmented. Roundworms. No body segments. Flatworms. Body is covered with cuticle. Roundworms. Body is covered by thin cuticle. Flatworms. They are hermaphrodites, having male and female sex organs in a single individual. Roundworms, sexes are separate. Flatworms, they are parasites. Roundworms, they exist as free living or as parasites. Third question, outline the flowcharts of phylum Chordata. Phylum Chordata, Vertebrata, Craniata and Prochordata, Acrania. Vertebrata, Craniata are divided into classes, pieces, example, fish class, amphibia, example, frog class, reptilia, example, lizard class, apes, example, dove class, mammalia, example, cat. Prochordata, Acrania. Subphylum Hemichordata, example, Balanoglossus. Subphylum Cephalochordata, example, Amphiosus. Subphylum Urochordata, example, Asexidian. Fourth question. List five characteristic features of fishes. Fishes are pachylothermic aquatic vertebrates with jaws. The body is streamlined. Locomotion is bipod and median fins. The body has a covering of scales. Body muscles are arranged into segments called myotomies. Question number 5. Comment on the aquatic and terrestrial habits of amphibians. Aquatic habits. Skin is moist and glandular. Respiration is through gills. Terrestrial habits. Long hind limbs for jumping. Respiration is through lungs. Sixth question. How are the limbs of the birds adapted for avian life? Answer. The birds have two pairs of limbs to accommodate the avian life. The four limbs are modified as wings. The hind limbs are adapted for walking and running. Answer in detail. Describe the characteristic features of different prochordates. The phylum Prochordates is classified into three subphyla, namely Hemichordata, Cephalochordata and urochordata. Subphylum Hemichordata. They are the marine organism without backbone. They are tubiculous form. The body is soft, vermiform, unsegmented, bilaterally symmetrical. They are triploblastic. The notochord is persistent as the stomochord in the anterior region of the animal. Example, Balanoglossus. Subphylum Cephalochordata. They are small fish-like marine chordates. They have unpaired dorsal fins. The persistent notochord extends forward beyond the brain. Example, Amphiosus. Subphylum Urochordata. The notochord is confined to the tail region of the larva. The adults are mostly degenerate and are sessile forms. The body is enveloped by a tunic or tuft. Example, Ascidian. Give an account on phylum Arthropoda. Arthropoda is an ancient and the largest phylum with more number of species. The word arthropod means jointed legs. The body of arthropods is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. The exoskeleton is made up of chitin. The colomic cavity is filled with hemolymph. They do not have well-defined blood vessels. The insects used to set its exoskeleton by molting. The respiration is through book, lungs, trachea. Excretion is through Malpighian tubules in insects and through green glands in crabs and prawns. Example, insects. Spider, crabs, shrimps, butterflies, millipedes, centipedes, and scorpions, etc. Thank you.